I'm Chris Edwards with Tennis Warehouse. I'm really excited to talk to you today about the world's first ever connected tennis racket. This is Babolat PLAY. So what is a connected tennis racket? Well, special features inside this Babolat PLAY Pure Drive, inside the handle, measure all kinds of different things while I'm out playing. There's an app which you can load on your smartphone or tablet, and with the two, you can track how many forehands you've hit, how many backhands you hit, the type of forehands and backhands you're hitting. It's like, am I hitting flat, slice, or topspin? It also measures the location of the ball hitting on the string bed, so I can see where in the string bed I'm hitting each of my shots. I can also track serves and overheads, and on all of my shots, it measures the amount of power, and that's through the racket head speed that I'm generating, and it also gives me an indication of how much spin I'm generating. And it gives everything as a percentage, and my percentage is ranked against the top 20 ATP players. So if I'm getting 60% power on my serve, I'm getting 60% power of a top 20 ATP player. This is the business end of the play racket. Right here at the butt cap, you see I've got two buttons, an upper button and a larger lower button. The upper button turns the play racket on. I just hold it down for a couple of seconds, and as soon as that little LED light there starts flashing blue, the racket's on, I go to play, it's gonna track everything during my session. If I wanna break down my training into two or more segments, what I do is I just hold the lower button down briefly, just for a second. That little LED will turn red, and then that means it's gonna break up the session. So if I wanted to, say, track my stats and swings and everything for the first set of a match, and then the following sets, like a second set, third set, I'll just hit that button to do so. The larger of the two buttons is also used to sync the racket to my smartphone. So what I do is I just hold it down for just a couple of seconds, and as soon as the LED starts flashing in purple, I know it's ready to sync to my phone. So all of my training sessions get logged in my phone once I've synced the racket to my phone. And if I just click on one right here, I can analyze what happened during that session. It only takes a few seconds for each one to load. And as you can see, I hit 282 shots in that session. My best rally was 12 shots long, so probably 24 shots between me and my opponent. If I scroll down, I can see how many backhands I hit and how many forehands I hit. Just hit a couple of smashes. I was playing ground stroke games, so I didn't hit any serves during this one, so we'll just skip right through that. And if I come to forehands right here, tap on forehands, and here's the breakdown of what my forehands were. So I hit 90 topspin forehands. My power was 46% of an ATP top 20 player. I hit 13 slice, so maybe a couple of those might be feeds or volleys. If you hit volleys, it's gonna up your flat count and your slice count. And then also I have 83 flat forehands. So those are either drive forehands or, again, when I moved up to the net to hit volleys. And then smaller here, you can see the amount of spin I'm getting, and the more dots you illuminate along that bottom bar right there will indicate on how much spin you're getting on the ball. If I go back up here now, we can go to my backhands right here. So I hit 94 backhands, that's indicated at the top. My average power is 43%. And then it breaks it down into my topspin, slice, and flat shots again. I hit a pretty flat ball when I drive through my backhand, so that numbers gets pretty high for me. And I'm showing, you know, decent power here, 47%. And then good spin too when I'm getting the slice and the topspin, starting to illuminate a few more of those bars on the spin line right there. So let's quick look at my backhands. Now if I come back into the app, I can come down and look at shot location. So I can do it for all strokes. It's an average of where I'm hitting the ball when I'm hitting all my strokes, and then I can do it by specific strokes. So here's my forehand. I'm hitting most of the shots high up in the string bed, and that's pretty common for most players that hit them with topspin. You're gonna hit high up in the string bed. It's just a natural part of hitting with topspin right there. And then you can see 11% lower down in the racket, and then a few of my not so good shots right there getting towards the throat and the edges. And then on the backhand, pretty similar story, 53% up there at the top of the racket. One of the fun parts about the Babolat PLAY is there's a community element to it. So as you can see, my global ranking right now is 11 in the community. There's not many of us testing these right now, so I'm sure I'm gonna drop down a bit when some of the harder players out there get connected. And another thing I really like is the pulse element. So if I go here, it gives me my average cumulative of what my technique, power, and endurance, and the amount of time I've been playing. And this is, generates my pulse. And so my pulse right now is 57.47. That means I've got to get out there and hit this racket a bit more and up my pulse. I like to try and keep it at least in the 60s. And you can see I've got technique here at the top, power, and then endurance. So if I'm working out longer, I've only hit the racket in short sections, and if I'm hitting harder, you'll see the bottom part of my pulse will start to spread out. And then if I keep hitting in, you know, a good part of the string bed too. My technique is going to improve too. So my pulse will grow, this number will go up, and that'll give me a higher ranking in the global community. The last part of the app we're going to look at right now is the skills section of the app. So if I just click on that right there, and this takes me to a level area of the app. And the verbiage is going to change a little bit here. I'm on a beta version of the app, so it might not say beginner there. They're still working on this part of the app. But what it does is it counts how many shots I've hit. And by completing the selected amount of shots, then it lets me to transfer up to the next level of the app. So right now I'm on the very first level because I've hit enough forehands. So I've got complete on forehands, complete on backhands. I have not hit enough serves. I've only done 55% of the required amount, but I have hit enough overhead. So as soon as I get my serves done to complete, I'll progress to the next level. And so with that being said, let's get out there and play, and I'll hit some serves. The great thing about Babolat PLAY is once you have the racket on, you can just play, you're ready to go. And you can do all the things that tennis players do. You can bounce the ball around, you know, you can spin your racket, you can take practice swings. It's not gonna register any of that. It's only gonna register when you take a swing, make contact with the ball. The sensors will recognize if the racket's in a plane like this and you're bouncing it, that is not a shot. So once you've got it on, all you have to do is feed the ball in and play. Well, that wraps it up for this little tutorial on Babolat PLAY. Be sure to check out our review, which will be posted shortly. We've got our review team hitting this racket too. Everyone's loving it. Everyone's loving seeing how much power and spin they're generating. We're definitely competing in the office to see who's hitting the most power and the most spin out there. So go get yourself connected. We'll see you out on the course.